Hello everyone. In this video, I will show you how to make a slope graph. Slope graph is really good at showing data and the change between two points in time. For example, in this graph, you can see that it is the data about the sales between the old and the new site of one of the department store. And you can see that all of the products sales increase from the old site to the new site. For example, meat, produce, package, which dramatically increased compared to other segment. Frozen food also increased daily except the cheese. So you see that we have two action colors, the orange and the light blue. Okay, the light blue showing the high increase and the orange show the drop of cells. Okay, so this is the story behind this graph. Now we are going to make this graph. So this is the data. I'm gonna take this out of the way, just delete it, and we're gonna make it from scratch. Okay, so first of all, you have to do you have to create the line graph. Okay, so basically just highlight it and just pick the line graph with the marker. So click on it, you have a line graph, and believe it or not, just one click, it will look almost like a slope graph. So let's take a look here. You switch row column. There you go. Almost there, right? But actually, we have to go through a few more steps, which probably gonna make your hand hurt. So let's see what we're gonna do next. We are going to stretch the graph a little further. And the way to do that is to you have to go to the format. Okay, format the chart. You have to format the let's see, what am I doing here? Okay, you have to go to format the axis option, and this is the x axis or the horizontal axis. Click on it. And then one thing that we have to do is we have to stretch this dot through the end to each side of the graph. So you might not seen this one before, but you can see that we have a between tick marks and on tick marks. So click on this one. You stretch the graph, right? See that? Okay, you stretch it out. So that's the first thing you gotta do. You stretch it out so that you occupy as much space as you want. The next thing you want to do is you want to change the look or the orientation of the graph by just like squeezing it, make it a little taller and narrower. Okay, so this way it look more like a slope graph, because we want to show the slope. We want it to be like narrow so that we can intensify the slope. All right, you don't need this one because we're gonna add it as a levels. Okay, you don't need that, and you also, you're not gonna need the number label, so you take that one off. Also, you want to decrease the plot area a little because we want to add some labels right on the plot. Okay, so take that off, and now the tedious part of all, and this is something that we have to go through, which is change the color. So, you know, I'm sorry to say that you have to change it one by one, and you have to change three things for each. So click on the series or one of the items, and then you have to change the color, but the color of the line and color of the marker. So you have to change all of that. We're gonna fade all these lines into gray color so that we can kind of show only the things that we want to show. All right, so you have to change this one to gray. I'm going to change the line first and change the marker later, so that way I don't have to switch the menu back and forth.
So click this one and change it to gray, and click this one also. Is it the same gray? Okay, it's correct. Change this one to gray as well. Now
go to the marker, then scroll down a little so that you have the feel. and you have the border, okay, fill in border. So click on it, change it to gray, click on it, change it to gray, and do it for every single one except the two lines that we want to highlight. Okay, that's kind of painful, right? So click on them, click on them and change. Okay, not too bad, right? Now you don't know what these lines represent. But one more thing, I'm gonna change this one to orange first. So let's do that. Change it to orange. Change it to orange, the line and the marker. Orange, and this one, the border also, change it to orange. And this line, change it to blue, it's the positive. So change to blue, back to the line, change it to blue. Okay, whew. So the colors are there. Now, we are going to call the labels. The easiest way is to like call everything out first and then we start deleting stuff later on. So I'm gonna add the charge element. Typically you click on the charge object and then you can click on adding the element. I'm gonna add the labels. Now you have a little more option here. Where do you want to put them? I'm gonna put them all in the on the left. Okay, on the left here. So now you have items, you have the values on the left. Next thing you want to do is you want to change them one by one again. So you have to go to click on it. Now, actually, this one, you want it to be on the right. Okay, the value here, you want to be on the right. So click on it. Again, don't forget that anytime you want to click just a single element, you have to click on that group of elements and you click one more time to get into that particular element. Just one. This is the one on the right, right? So click on it. We don't want the we don't want to show the line, and we want it to be on the right. Okay, so do that for every single one. Change it to the right. Change it to the right, this one also, change it to the right, this one, change it to the right, and last one. Okay, change it to the right. Kind of painful, isn't it? Now on the left here, we want to make use of the labels. So we want to show the name. So that's a Siri name. So click on it. Not for both, but just for the left hand side item. So click on it and click on Siri name. That's meat, right? And this one also, click on the Siri name. This one also, click on the Siri name. No need for the line. This one, the Siri and no line. This one also, Siri, no line. And one more thing here. Well, we can't really see it, so I'm gonna stretch it out so that you can click it. Okay, I take this one and then again click on the Siri no line. Okay, so now you have it, but the problem is that they kind of mess up a little because they're too close to one another. So this way, there are quite a few things you can do. You can squeeze it into, squeeze it in a little so you add more space, right? Okay, another thing that you should do is, sometimes you might not want that comma. How are we going to get rid of that comma? Click on it, label option again, the separator. No need for anything, right? Just a space. Now, separator, space. Separator, space. Also this one, just a space. Okay, you can see that we make it into one line. Okay, I think you made a little mistake here. I'm gonna click on it. I'm gonna remove the values, okay, the Siri name. Okay, now it looks a little better. Now we are going to adjust it in a way that we can see them all clearly. So this one is what? This one is the package, right? Package is on top of the, this one is frozen, so the package is right here, a little on top here, so move it up. Okay. Frozen. Okay, well, we can fix this later once we see which is which. So this one is package, right? So change the color of the font as well so that you know where you're looking at, right? And then cheese is in orange, so change that too, make it bold. Okay, now it's a lot clearer, right? You put things in the wrong location. So I'm gonna move this down. Frozen, you move it on top here. Okay. So see, what do we need more? So we have all the color and then a couple more things. What you need to do now is all of this, you want to fade it down, right? Because you have the color in gray. So probably you want to change it to gray as well. All of this. I'm going to change all of this to gray. Okay. All the labels to gray. And this one also. Now, next thing you want to do is you want to have the line shooting up so that it kind of lock the space of this marker. Okay, it helps the eyes to see the block just a little bit better. So all you have to do is click on this labels and then right click on add the major grid line. See that? You click add the major grid line here. It's already there, right? So you have the major grid line right here, which is also in gray color. And maybe you don't need this line because you wanna have this marker lock the vertical line from left to right, but you don't need the grid line on the vertical side. So go to the horizontal. Wait, here. Okay, this one. Major grid line option for the verticals values, you probably don't need that. So I'm gonna go to the line, gonna go to no line, because you don't need that, right? It's kind of making a little more clearly this way. Now, really, really last thing here is to add the title. So you're gonna say something like, right, you say after the move to the new site, sales increase almost everywhere except for cheese. So change it to orange to match, and then change the alignment, and then move it to the left so that we can draw the audience to the left first. So that's it. That's the slope graph.